And here we go with the former UFC title challenger, Iron Michael Chandler. Daniel, you guys go way back. Obviously, we can talk about the athletic credentials. Some, though, have questioned his fight IQ in some of his big fights in the UFC.
Well, it seems like he wants to fight the fun fight,
right,
opposed to the fight that would seem to make sense to him. But let me tell you something, I'm not complaining. I enjoy every Michael Chandler fight. I enjoy watching this guy go out there and fight on his shield. He has A-plus skills across the board, and let's see how he applies them to the fight tonight.
And even in losses against high-level competition, he has had big moments. You do get the sense that Michael Chandler may always be just one win away from that elusive shot at the title yet again. The Octagon with his mind set on one thing tonight, that UFC championship belt. So here he is, DC, the biggest superstar in mixed martial arts history, former two-division UFC champion Conor McGregor. And a lot of people thought maybe he wouldn't come back to the proving ground. He's got a lot to prove when it comes to his MMA legacy, and as such, McGregor returns to the Octagon here tonight.
When you talk about Conor McGregor, you're talking about a star that transcends mixed martial arts. We've seen a lot of people come and go, but no one has ever reached the level of Conor McGregor. And you think he's just a talker. No, there is a ton of substance to everything that he does. From the moment he stepped into the Octagon, he said what he was gonna do, and he eventually did it. From knocking guys out left and right to becoming a two-division champion, knocked out Jose Aldo, knocked out Eddie Alvarez. There's just too much to say about the notorious.
And I'm glad you put it that way, because he is this larger-than-life character, and I think at times people lose sight of just how skilled a martial artist this is. Elite striker, tremendous distance management. Few move better on the feet than Conor McGregor, and we'll look to put those striking skills to good use yet again tonight as Conor McGregor returns. Conor McGregor has stepped inside the Octagon. The notorious one is ready to fight. Our tail of the tape now for this lightweight championship fight. We set it inside the Octagon. We find Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! 5 rounds for the UFC Lightweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the challenger, Iron Michael Chandler. Now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, the notorious Conor McGregor!
Herb Dean, our third man in the Octagon for this one.
Let's do it.
All right, so here we go with the Ultimate Fighter coaches, Conor McGregor and Michael Chandler. I don't have to tell you this, champ, but Michael Chandler, part of the reason he signed with the UFC was with the hopes that this McGregor fight would materialize. And tonight, here we are.
Yeah, and Chandler's getting another big fight. You can win fights and you can be very fun. And even if you lose, you don't lose. Michael Chandler has proven that time and time again. He is an absolute powerhouse at lightweight. And he will look to impose himself on a notorious one, Conor McGregor.
Beautiful combination of punches to the head. He gets tagged again. All right, clinch situation here, pursued by the wrestler, and a nice job to get inside against the kickboxer, who candidly doesn't like this dirty boxing on the inside.
He doesn't want to be close. He wants space. He wants things to look clean. This wrestler wants to grind on you and wants to wear you down. He wants to make you carry his weight for as long as you're inside the Octagon. It is so exhausting and fatiguing to fight this type of fight.
Oh, huge
Chandler is a sight to behold, man. He's so dangerous, he's so strong physically, and he has so much belief in his strength and his ability to fight at a high pace that he won't slow down. What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high with his opponent, but he was going low, and now he's got him hurt very badly.
Man, back and forth we go, and early on, these guys getting after it.
They told us it would be fun, and so far, they delivered.
Just over 3 minutes to go.
Great job finding an opening and landing a beautiful punch from the clinch.
Leg kick. Well, I'm no fighter, but if I rock a guy to that extent, I feel like I'm closing the show.
Absolutely. You gotta go close the show if you get a guy hurt that bad. You cannot back off. He's ripe for the picking. Go and pick the fruit.
Oh, and there's the kick. That one checked by McGregor. Under 2 minutes to go in a back-and-forth first round here. Oh, nice job defensively to sprawl and avoid that double-leg takedown. Chandler's bleeding from the mouth, Daniel. Looks as though there's a cut on his lip. Thankfully, he's a lot tougher than I am.
Oh, he did a great job of rotating him into an underhook.
Now some spacing as they exit the clinch. Start to see some bruising appearing on the torso and all of that courtesy of the body work of his opponent.
Just the wherewithal to go to the body and the discipline to stay with that approach. I mean, it's just tremendous. You see a fighter with a high fight IQ following a game plan, and it's working.
Making all these shots count. All right, inside his opponent's guard here, DC. You don't want to play around here too long.
No, you got to either have two hands in or two hands out, or guys start to attack triangle.
Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by McGregor. Solid kick right there. Seconds now remain in the round. Oh, wow, how about the roundhouse kick? Round one winding down here. Oh, well, why get away from it? Another huge kick lands. Chandler's nose is bleeding now. Looks to be cut perhaps there on the bridge. That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, there's the horn. The round is over, but not before he was cut on his nose from the strikes in that round. Back to the stool. Cut man is in. Should be able to shut that cut and prevent it from becoming an issue moving forward. But, of course, as soon as he gets struck in that next round, it could open back up. So the crowd voicing its appreciation after that round. We had a knockdown courtesy of a punch midway through. DC, here's your highlight.
It was straight. He threw him in combination and landed that big punch that really did hurt his opponent. Lesser men would have been done. He's got a tough guy in front of him. He will have to go back to this again. He will have to get back to this action if he wants to get the desired finish.
Second round underway. Well, an appreciative capacity crowd on its feet as this next round gets underway. That previous round, you get the bonus checks ready. That was insane.
It's done. These guys are taking over $50,000. They laid it all along the line. They dropped a quarter in the middle of the octagon, and they said, let's go. What a round.
That is a huge shot. DC, you don't want to eat too many more of those.
No, and he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad. Oh!
Oh, roundhouse kick. Style points on that one. Nice crack there. Right, so the hands are crispy tonight. Not exactly what we thought we would see out of this wrestler, but as a former two-time U.S. Olympian yourself with some hands, you can fall in love with this.
You can fall in love with the striking, but he is showing tonight that everybody should love
him. Ooh, dive and punch lands. Oh, man, another strike gets through. This could be over soon. Back to his feet. Well, no denying the durability on the other side, but at this point, you just got to find that kill shot and get him out of there.
A lot of times that comes with reps. That comes
with reps. He gets on the feet. His opponent in a lot of trouble now.
That was Cain Velasquez's punch of choice. Every time he lands that overhand right, he hurt you bad. And this guy has his opponent hurt very badly again.
Seems as though his sole focus is attacking that cut, and man, it's getting bad now. A lot of blood flowing.
Yeah, as it should be. Well, he should be focused on getting to that cut, making his opponent pay. He did the work. He opened, and now he's attempting to choke.
Ooh, this could be it. That thing is tight.
That arm tackle is deep. Oh, he's getting submitted.
Oh, he escapes.
He got out. I mean, wow, that is great submission defense.
Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in, and you got all your rear choke submissions.
Well, it's been a wild fight thus far. Perhaps a contender for some bonus money at fight's end. These guys are going to have to dig deep. They're both hurt.
They're both hurt. You expected it, though. You expected a close fight. You did not expect a war like this, though, where both guys, from the moment they said fight, went forward, got in each other's face, and just beat each other up. It's been tremendous.
Man, that is loud. Another strike lands for the kickboxer. He really found that flow state pretty early in this fight, and he hasn't looked back.
He found it really early. And when this guy gets into his groove, he is hell on wheels. And right now he is showing why he is such a high-level, high-regarded kickboxer. He is outclassing this guy.
Oh, McGregor's looking to go from the full to the half guard here. Opponent not having it. Well, nothing in the unified rules says you can't strike from off of your back, and he did well there. McGregor's in half guard. Oh, trying to pass here, but Dikembe Mutombo style, he gets denied.
Blocked! Great job blocking that pass by the bottom fighter.
All right, so yet another ground and pound strike lands right there, DC.
He's getting very active now that he knows he can land these strikes.
Spot on the ground and you want to reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing position, unreal to see.
This is some exhausting work, man.
I mean, it is so tiring to be fighting in this way. So much wrestling, so much grappling, expending all this energy trying to hold the guy down. I mean, no takedown is not fought. No reversal is not fought. Everything they're doing is fought to the very last minute before it gets given up.
Chandler ground and pound from half guard. So wisely, he continues to attack that area that is cut wide open. When you were fighting, was that something you would do? You see a cut, try to attack it?
It's like a target. Yeah. I mean, you want to get your hands on that cut. You want to punch him in it. You want to elbow him in it. Anytime you see your work paying off, you go down the path.
Look how excited you just got talking about punching a dude who's already wide open. Like, you got really excited.
It is, right? And I'm old now. I don't even want to fight no more, but I do love a little damage.
All right, there's the horn indicating the end of the round. So potentially a big factor here, ladies and gentlemen. The cut on the cheek sustained in that round. Certainly better to be below than above the eye, but the cut man's got to get in there and close that thing up. All right, let's check out some of the action, DC, and how about the punching acumen by that fighter in that previous round?
He does not waste anything. He does not loop punches. Everything's tight. Everything's precise. He's a sniper. We always talk about how he's a sniper. He is a sniper, and it showed in that exchange that allowed him to drop his opponent.
Ready to fight. Ready.
All right, here we go with this third round of this championship fight. Back to the overhand now. That one's good. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Swing and a miss by Michael Chandler.
Oh, he's hurt bad.
Oh, nice.
Trying to go to the body now with the kick. That one misses.
When both are prepared, these are the types of fights that we expect.
That is gonna do it!
Oh my goodness!
I mean, you gotta be kidding me with that knockout. If that is not the number one play on SportsCenter tonight, I'm not sure what would top it. One of the best knockouts we've seen all year.
In a very long time. I have not seen someone look this good. He promised us something and he delivered with that beautiful knockout.
The official decision is now in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 59 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, the notorious Conor.
All right, well, as many of you know, the overwhelming majority of Conor McGregor's pro